Belinda presents this unabridged recording of The Story of Tracy Beaker, written by Jacqueline Wilson and read by Sandi Toksvig.
I'm Tracy Beaker. This is a book all about me. It's the most incredible, dynamic, heart-rending story. Honest. And I bet some great movie magnate spots it and turns it into a film, and I'll get to be the star. Just like my mum. I suppose I'd better let Peter have a small part in my film. But not Louise or Justine. No way. Cam can write the script if she likes. Cam is... But if you want to know who she is, you'd better listen to the story. There's some funny bits and some rude bits and some sad bits, and I think it's the best book ever. But then I would do, seeing as I helped write it. My book about me. About me. My name is Tracy Beaker. I am 10 years, 2 months old. My birthday is on the 8th of May. It's not fair, because that dopey Peter Ingham has his birthday then too, so we just got the one cake between us. And we had to hold the knife to cut the cake together, which meant we only had half a wish each. Wishing is for babies, anyway. They don't come true. I was born at... some hospital somewhere. I looked cute when I was a little baby, but I bet I yelled a lot. I am... centimetres tall. I don't know. I've tried measuring with a ruler, but it keeps wobbling about, and I can't reach properly. I don't want to get any of the other children to help me. This is my private book. I weigh kilos. I don't know that either. Jenny has got scales in her bathroom, but they're stones and pounds. I don't weigh many of them. I'm a little titch. My eyes are black, and I can make them go all wicked and witchy. I quite fancy being a witch. I'd make up all these incredibly evil spells and wave my wand and zap! Louise's golden curls would all fall out and zap! Peter Ingham's silly, squeaky voice would get sillier and squeakier, and he'd grow whiskers and a long tail and zap! There's not room on this bit of the page, but I've still got all sorts of zaps inside my head. My hair is fair and very long and curly. I'm telling fibs. It's dark and difficult and it sticks up in all the wrong places. My skin is spotty when I eat a lot of sweets. Stick a photo of yourself here. Oh. I'm not really cross-eyed. I was just pulling a silly face. I started this book on... I don't know. Who cares what the date is? You always have to put the date at school. I got fed up with this and put 2091 in my day book and wrote about all these rockets and spaceships and monsters legging it down from Mars to eat us all up, as if we'd all whizzed 100 years into the future. Miss Brown didn't half get narked. More things about me. Things I like. My lucky number is 7. So why didn't I get fostered by some fantastic rich family when I was 7 then? My favourite colour is blood red, so watch out. My best friend is... Well, I've had heaps and heaps, but Louise has gone off with Justine and now I haven't got anyone just at the moment. I like eating... everything. I like birthday cake best, and any other kind of cake, and Smarties and Mars bars and big buckets of popcorn and jelly spiders and Cornettos and Big Macs with French fries and strawberry milkshakes. My favourite name is Camilla. There was a lovely little baby at this other home, and that was her name. She was a really sweet kid with fantastic hair that I used to try to get into loads of little plaits, and it must have hurt her sometimes, but she never cried. She really liked me, little Camilla. She got fostered quick as a wink. I begged her foster mum and dad to bring her back to see me, but they never did. I like drinking pints of bitter. That's a joke. I have had a sip of lager once, but I didn't like it. My favourite game is playing with makeup. Louise and I once borrowed some from Adele, who's got heaps. Louise was a bit boring and just tried to make herself look beautiful. I turned myself into an incredible vampire with evil, shadowy eyes and blood dribbling down my chin. I didn't half scare the little ones. My favourite animal is... well, there's a rabbit called Lettuce at this home, but it's a bit limp like its name. It doesn't sit up and give you a friendly lick like a dog. I think I'd like a Rottweiler. And then all my enemies had better watch out. My favourite TV programme is horror films. Best of all, I like being with my mum. Things I don't like, the name Justine, Louise, Peter. Oh, there's heaps and heaps of names I can't stand. Eating stew, especially when it's got great fatty lumps in it. I used to have this horrid foster mother called Auntie Peggy, and she was an awful cook. She used to make this slimy stew like molten sick, and we were supposed to eat it all up, every single bit. Oh, yuck! Most of all, I hate Justine, that monster gorilla, and not seeing my mum. My own family. Stick a photo of you and your family here. This was when I was a baby. See? I was sweet then. And this is my mum. She's ever so pretty. I wish I looked more like her. The people in my own family are... my mum. I don't have a dad. I lived with my mum when I was little, and we got on great. But then she got this monster gorilla boyfriend, and I hated him, and he hated me back and beat me up, and so I had to be taken into care. No wonder my mum sent him packing. My own family live at... I'm not sure exactly where my mum lives now, because she has to keep moving about, because she gets fed up living in one place for long. The phone number is... I don't know, do I? Funny, though, I always used to bag this toy telephone in the playhouse at school and pretend I was phoning my mum. I used to have these long, long conversations with her. They were just pretend, of course, but I was only about 5 then, and sometimes it got to be quite real. Things about my family that I like. I like my mum. Because she's pretty and good fun, and she brings me lovely presents. My foster family. There's no point filling this bit in. I haven't got a foster family at the moment. I've had 2. There was Auntie Peggy and Uncle Sid, first of all. I didn't like them much, and I didn't get on with the other kids, so I didn't care when they got rid of me. I was in a children's home for a while, and then I had this other couple, Julie and Ted. They were young and friendly, and they bought me a bike, and I thought it was all going to be great. And I went to live with them, and I was ever so good and did everything they said, and I thought I'd be staying with them until my mum came to get me for good. But then... I don't want to write about it. It ended up with me getting turfed out through no fault of my own. I was so mad I smashed up the bike, so I don't even have that anymore. And now I'm in a new children's home, and they've advertised me in the papers... but there weren't many takers, and now I think they're getting a bit desperate. I don't care, though. I expect my mum will come soon anyway. My school. My school is called... it's Kingley Junior School. I've been to 3 other schools already. This one's okay, I suppose. My teacher is called... Miss Brown. She gets cross if we just call her Miss. subjects I do. Story writing, arithmetic, games, art, all sorts of things. And we do projects. Only I never have the right stuff at the home, so I can't do it properly and get a star. I like story writing best. I've written heaps of stories, and I do pictures for them too. I make some of them into books. I made Camilla a special baby book with big printed words and pictures of all the things she liked best. Things like Teddy and ice cream and your special friend Tracy. I also like art. We use poster paints. We've got them at the home too, but they get all gungy and mucked up and the brushes are useless. They've got good ones at school. This is a painting I did yesterday. If I was a teacher, I'd give it a gold star. 2 gold stars. My class is 3A. People in my class. I can't list all their names. I'd be here all night. I don't know some of them yet, but there's not much point making friends because I expect I'll be moving on soon. Other teachers. Oh, they're all boring. Who wants to write about them? I get to school by going in the minibus. That's how all the kids in the home get to school. I'd sooner go in a proper car or walk it by myself, but you're not allowed. It takes hours. Mins. But it varies. Sometimes it takes ages because the little kids can't find their pencil cases and the big ones try to bunk off and we just have to hang about waiting. Things I don't like about school. They all wear grey things. That's the uniform. And I've only got navy things from my last school. The teachers know why and I don't get into trouble. But the other kids stare. Being in care. My social worker is called Elaine, and sometimes she's a right pain. We talk about all sorts of boring things. But I don't like talking about my mum. Not to Elaine. What I think about my mum is private. If I was older, I would live in this really great modern house all on my own, and I'd have my own huge bedroom with all my own things, special bunk beds just for me so that I'd always get the top one, and a Mickey Mouse alarm clock like Justine's, and my own giant set of poster paints, and I'd have some felt tips as well, and no one would ever get to borrow them and mess them up, and I'd have my own television and choose exactly what programmes I want, and I'd stay up till gone 12 every night, and I'd eat at McDonald's every single day, and I'd have a big fast car so I could whiz off and visit my mum whenever I wanted. If I was a policeman, I would arrest the monster gorilla and I'd lock him up in prison forever. A kitten, I would grow very long claws and sharp teeth and scratch and bite everyone so they'd get really scared of me and do everything I say. Yelled at, I would yell back. Invisible, I would spy on people. Very tall, I would stamp on people with my great big feet. Very rich, I would buy my own house and then... I've done all that bit. I'm getting fed up writing all this. What's on the next page? My own story. Use this space to write your story. The story of Tracy Beaker. Once upon a time, there was a little girl called Tracy Beaker. That sounds a bit stupid. Like the start of a soppy fairy story. I can't stand fairy stories. They're all the same. If you're very good and very beautiful with long golden curls, then, after sweeping up a few cinders or having a long kip in a cobwebby palace, this prince comes along and you live happily ever after. Which is fine if you happen to be a goody-goody and look gorgeous. But if you're bad and ugly, then you've got no chance whatsoever. You get given a silly name like Rumpelstiltskin, and nobody invites you to their party, and no one's ever grateful, even when you do them a whopping great favour. So of course you get a bit cheesed off with this sort of treatment. You stamp your feet in a rage and fall right through the floorboards, or you scream yourself into a frenzy, and you get locked up in a tower and they throw away the key. I've done a bit of stamping and screaming in my time, and I've been locked up heaps of times. Once, they locked me up all day long, and all night. That was at the first home, when I wouldn't settle because I wanted my mum so much. I was just little then, but they still locked me up. I'm not fibbing. Although, I do have a tendency to tell a few fibs now and again. It's funny. Auntie Peggy used to call it telling fairies.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.